Hello my crafty friends and welcome back to another card making video. Today I will create mini slimline cards using layered stencils. And when it comes to this type of stencils, Pinkfresh Studio has a big variety and their designs not only come in a bunch of layered stencils, but you can also get the same design as a stamp as well as a die. So you can easily mix and match them together to get your looks. Now the fun part about this die set is that it cuts out all the different bunches of flowers, but they are all connected, making your life super easy. So I will be using these three products today as my example, and these are the Be Strong set. This is from a previous release by my Pinkfresh Studio, and I decided to omit completely the stamp. So I'm not going for a black outline this time, but I will use the sentiments from this stamp set. There are lovely sentiments included. Now let's take a closer look on the layered stencils. There are five different stencils included in the set. And you can layer one on top of the other really easy. At the top you will find engraved the number of the stencils. So you can just go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And there is also a little indentation that gives you the A2 card size, so you can easily layer it on top of your panel. However, I'm going to show you my way of layering these super quickly without measuring or trying to place them correctly on top of one another. I'm bringing in my Misty, and all I need that is for using that edge up at the top. Align your paper and then on top align the first stencil. Just make sure that you push the corners up at the top. I will use, however, a piece of tape on my paper just to make sure that it's going to stay put, so that when I move and change the stencils, I don't have to worry about the paper underneath. Any blending tool that you have works here. I'm going with one of my blending brushes and I'm starting with Meadow. Now the first stencil is all about the leaves. It's going to give you the first layer of the leaves, and there are only two layers here, so just decide a lighter and a darker color that you want to use and go for it. So once I'm happy with the first layer, I'm going to lift the stencil so you can see what we have up to now. Now I'm going to leave this stencil aside and bring in the stencil which is marked number 2. And again I'm aligning it at the top right corner. And by doing that quick and simple movement, you know that it falls exactly where it should be. For my flowers, I'm going with this set of 4 inks by Pinkfresh Studio. I'm going to omit the lighter one and I will start with the second shade, which is Sparkling Rose. Again, I'm going to cover up with this ink any opening that there is available in this stencil, so you don't have to think a second time, you don't have to mask off areas, just choose a color and go for it. And I will continue in the same manner, so I'm going to grab the stencil number 3, again I'm going to align it at the top right corner, and you know that it's going to fall perfectly on top of your design. This time I'm going with one shade darker, which is Bubblegum. By the way, I'm not changing a blending tool, I'm using the same one for all the shades of pink. I don't even need to clean it up, since I'm starting from the lighter and going all the way to the darker shade. So if you notice, for the flowers there are 3 stencils. This is the 4th stencil, 3rd for the flower. And again I'm going with one shade darker. This is a Raspberry Bliss. It's going to finish off my flowers and it's going to give that extra dark shade that I always like. It really helps those designs come to life. And finally, the 5th stencil is for adding that shading on top of the leaves. So here I'm using a shade darker than the previous green one. This is Emerald City, which is going to finish off my designs. And without too much effort, you get amazing flowers. Now the fun part about this die is that once you layer it on top, it's going to cut them all out at once. So you don't have to align each die separately, which makes die cutting so much easier. And I have the feeling that with all those amazing dies out there, we are getting really spoiled. So here are my lovely branches. I have a bunch of them ready to go and I can create a couple of cards. I'm going for a couple of mini slimline cards, since I have enough flowers here. And for all of my cards, I'm going to play with the new Essentials dies by Pinkfresh Studio. This is part of a blog haul, by the way, and there are lots of giveaways. Make sure to visit my blog to find out all about it. So you can see it comes with many different dies that you can layer. The two have lovely details on the edges. There are also matching circles that you can layer on top of your panels. You can create windows or cut out pieces and pop them on top to add your sentiments or your focal points. And again, you can play around with different designs. Absolutely lovely die set, and it is one of the essentials that you can use throughout the year again and again, especially if you love the mini slimline card. I'm kind of obsessed with this size lately, and I find it super adorable. So here all I'm doing is creating a panel. I'm just layering some of the circles and the rectangles from the set to create a little panel, and this way I'm creating a window to tuck inside my flowers that I have already created. I absolutely love the lovely design on that circle. It adds that extra touch to the panel. I'm just adding foam tape at the back so that I can pop it on top of another panel that I cut using rectangles from the same set. And although in the beginning I was planning to use a panel that was matching the color of my flowers, I decided not to go so vibrant and go more like clean and simple and more elegant. So I went with an off-white cardstock, a kind of a creamy one, and I'm just tucking inside a couple of those flowers that I created. All I need to do is to add the sentiment. I did white emboss the sentiment on a black strip of cardstock. And now to finish it off, I'm adding some of those gems just to add some sparkle here and there. It's a lovely card design. I absolutely love the detail on the circle of my window. And I think it is a card for pretty much any occasion. Just change the sentiment and you are good to go. Here are some close-up photos on the first card for today, and since I still have a bunch of more flowers that I created, let's make a second card using again the same Essentials Mini Slimline Card die set. Again, I'm going for the same color combo with white and vanilla on top, and I did also die cut a circle to add my sentiment. Now you can see here that I did stamp the sentiment from the Be Strong stamp set by using the darkest ink of the pink ones that I used, which was Raspberry Bliss. However, I didn't like how it looked, and that's why I am going to later on change that. I will change it in a bit, but for now let's tag underneath that sentiment the flowers. And of course, for this step you can go completely flat, just stick them down with your glue. Or you can even go with tiny little foam tapes at the back, which is something that I did to add dimension. And here is finally what I did for the center. I just white embossed that sentiment one more time on black cardstock, and I placed it directly on top. This way I don't lose that layer of white from the background, and at the same time that layer did have some detail, which really makes a difference, a cutout detail all around. I'm also going to finish off my card by adding some of those gems. I have been using these gems for years now. They are by Pinkfresh Studio, and they do have refills if you feel like you want to grab only a few of those colors. However, I find that once you get a set, it kind of lasts forever. I keep on using them again and again on my cards, and they are still full. But if you don't have any, check them out on their website. You will find that they come in a lovely pouch, which is reusable. So here are my two cards, and now I'm going to show you how you can make a mini slimline card. If you don't have envelopes, you can use this die that is going to help you personalize your envelopes, making them match your card, or even use pattern papers for that. You can see that the big die fits on a letter-sized cardstock. So you need to cut out this piece once and the other smaller piece two times. And although this looks quite big, trust me, it fits inside your standard die cutting machine. So here I have my Spellbinders cutting plates. Now this set of dies not only cuts out the pieces that you need to create your envelope, but it also creates folding lines. So all you have to do is to fold them and just go over them with your bone folder to make sure that you have a nice crease there. And then add some double-sided tape on the flaps and stick everything together. So I'm placing one flap on one side, the other flap on the other side. And for this envelope I did use cardstock, but you can easily use pattern paper if you like, which is thinner. Actually, it would make a better envelope, not as stiff as mine or as thick. Plus you can match the pattern paper that you probably have used on your actual card. Now you can see that this envelope fits nicely both of my cards, even if some of the leaves go outside of the borders. and you can customize it even more by adding some stenciling maybe or some stamping using the same products as the ones that you used on the card to match everything nicely. So here are some close-up photos on all the cards that I made for today. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired. Just like always, you will find links to everything I used down below in the description area. And also don't forget, this is part of a blog hop with lots of giveaways. Make sure to visit my blog to find all about it. Don't forget to like the video, it really helps, and also leave me a comment. Thank you all so much for joining me today, and I hope you'll all have a lovely day.